Χαίρομαι πάρα πολύ που σας υποδέχομαι σήμερα στο Μέγαρο Μαξίμου. Το θέμα της σημερινής μας συνάντησης έχει περιεχόμενο ουσιαστικό, αλλά πιστεύω ότι έχει και μια πολύ μεγάλη συμβολική σημασία. Γιατί ενώ αποτελεί ένα βήμα στο ψηφιακό αύριο της χώρας, συμβαίνει την επόμενη ακριβώς της ολοκλήρωσης δημοπράτησης των συχνοτήτων για τα δίκτυα πέμπτης γενιάς. Είναι μια διαδικασία που έφερε 372 εκατομμύρια στα δημόσια ταμεία. Έγινε πράξη μέσα σε 12 μήνες. Απαιτούσε πάρα πολλές προαπαιτούμενες ενέργειες, οι οποίες έγιναν εν μέσω πανδημίας. Και με αυτόν τον τρόπο, κράτος, επιχειρήσεις, πολίτες αποκτούν πρόσβαση σε νέες δυνατότητες που μόνο η υψηλή τεχνολογία μπορεί να προσφέρει. Ο διαγωνισμός έγινε με διαφάνεια, έγινε με διορατικότητα. Δημοπρατήθηκε σχεδόν όλο το φάσμα των διαθέσιμων συχνοτήτων, αλλά ένα μέρος τους διακρατήθηκε για να παραχωρηθεί χωρίς κόστος σε πανεπιστήμια, σε start-up, σε ερευνητικά κέντρα. Με άλλα λόγια, η διευκόλυνση της καθημερινής ζωής και της οικονομικής δράσης συνδυάζεται με την ενίσχυση της καινοτομίας και της επιχειρηματικότητας. Επίσης, πάρα πολύ σημαντικό ότι το 25% των τελών που θα καταβάλουν υπάροχοι για το 5G θα κατευθυνθεί στο Ταμείο Φεστός, ένα καινούριο ταμείο το οποίο έχουμε δημιουργήσει, το οποίο με τη σειρά του θα χρηματοδοτεί νεοφυείς επιχειρήσεις με αντικείμενο εφαρμογές και υπηρεσίες βασισμένες στα νέα δίκτυα. Θέλουμε να δημιουργήσουμε και στη χώρα μας ένα οικοσύστημα γύρω από το 5G. Έχουμε, πιστεύω, τα μυαλά, τα ταλέντα που αυτό μπορούν να το κάνουν και να το υπηρετήσουν. Θα περιμένω με πολύ μεγάλο ενδιαφέρον τις δικές σας εξαγγελίες για την ταχύτητα με την οποία θα ενεργοποιήσετε το δικό σας δίκτυο 5G. Και νομίζω ότι θα πρέπει να αρχίσουμε να εξηγούμε και στους πολίτες, στους χρήστες αυτών των υπηρεσιών, πόσο πολύ μπορεί να αλλάξει η ζωή τους με τις πολύ αυξημένες ταχύτητες που το 5G μπορεί να παρέχει. Και βέβαια πώς μπορεί να μας ανοίξει καινούργιες πόρτες σε υπηρεσίες οι οποίες μέχρι σήμερα δεν μπορούν να υποστηριχθούν με τα υφιστάμενα δίκτυα, όπως παραδείγματος χάρη προχωρημένες υπηρεσίες τηλεατρικής που τόσο επίκαιρες είναι και λόγω COVID. Σταματώ εδώ. I'll stop here. I said a few words about the auction process and just to repeat how excited we are to have you here in Greece, to reiterate how quickly the ministry went ahead with the auction process in spite of the difficulties that were obviously due to the COVID pandemic. We're happy that you continue to support the Greek business with significant investment, and very eager to hear how you plan to move forward, especially with you know, the 5G services that I understand you're ready to initiate.
So, Kalimera, first, welcome and thank you. I'm very honored. We are very honored that we have the opportunity meeting you here today. It's an important day for Greece. As one of the first countries in Europe, you're getting a 5G network. And Deutsche Telekom and OTE is, let's say, the front runner, the ones, you know, who want to have the first call and the first connectivity. It has been months since I have traveled. Mm-hmm. So that's my first travel. By the way, we met for the third time this year. That mm-hmm. shows, you know, how strong the relationship has been built over the years. And we are very happy to be in Greece with our entity OTE. Now, 5G, very important. We are building a new category of networks with almost 1,000 times more capacity, with 100 times more speed, and with a latency, so a ping time, which is 10 times lower than what we have today. And this will enable, on the one side, everything for consumers. So at home, you can do home connectivity. You can substitute your fixed line, maybe. You can do gaming at home. You can do 8K video streaming at home. But on the street, on the business side, it will enable a new category of Internet of Things. Mm-hmm. It will enable much better connectivity for cars, for logistics. It will even automate production process and substitute wireless LAN. Mm-hmm. So a new kind of connecting things is what 5G enables, and therefore it's so important. The first networks in Europe were in our footprint, Germany and Austria, and now number three, Greece. Mm-hmm. So I like to say thank you because you were very fast in the auction process of the spectrum, which is for us the real estate on which we are building our houses. Without the real estate, you will not have 5G. So spectrum is very important, and we are happy to be here. Deutsche Telekom, just my last sentence, is now by far the biggest telco in Europe. We are as big as Vodafone and Orange together, to just give you a size on our valuation. We are covering 260 million customers. So even by customer size, we are now biggest. And the most important thing for customers, in 13 countries, we are running networks like here in Greece. And in 12 of the 13 countries, we have won all network tests. So our ambition is to have the number one mobile network in this country. And therefore, we want to be first on 5G. We want to be faster from a coverage and from a speed perspective. And that is why it's so important that we are here today. Deutsche Telekom is investing 17 billion euros on an annual basis. And we are investing 600 million only in Greece into the infrastructure on an annual basis. So this is, let's say, the big numbers which we are carrying out. And now the promise which we're going to make, and we are German engineers, we want to have 50% of Greek population being covered by the end of next year, and 100% of all the streets, you know, are covered within the next 2 years, so that we are really able to connect this country and bring it up to the front of digitization in Europe. There's a lot to do. I think we can do a lot of things together, and therefore, I really appreciate it, Faristo, for having me.
Thank you. These are extremely encouraging words, and I'm happy that you recognize how quickly we have moved in order to be able to deliver, as you said, the real estate upon which you will build your network. You know, very, very excited that you're moving so quickly. We want a vibrant, you know, competitive 5G ecosystem. Yeah. And what I can tell you is that this digital transformation of the country is one of my two main priorities. It also fits very well with the ambitions put forward by the recovery fund. The minister has been very keen on submitting proposals that can be funded from the recovery fund, and we also have now for the first time a codified what we call the Digital Bible, which is essentially all the big infrastructure projects that will allow us to move forward with the digitization of state and society. And interestingly enough, the pandemic has demonstrated that if you can actually work from anywhere, this is an important proposition for the country. We want to encourage more people to come to Greece, not just to visit Greece, but to work from Greece. But in order to be able to do that, we need powerful networks to ensure connectivity. So this is double important, not just for the Greek population, but we do want to turn Greece into a destination for people to work from people to retire. And in this overall plan, connectivity plays a crucial, absolutely crucial role. And we've demonstrated that in spite of the constraints, you know, of the current system, we have been able also to deliver digital services to all Greeks who actually required them. Just one example, we currently have all our classrooms in digital format, 100,000 classrooms a day. And we know that digital education in the future will go hand in hand with real education. But in order to deliver the best possible experience, we need networks, we need speed, we need, you know, some of the capacities that will be offered from the new technology.
This is iPhone 12. Mm-hmm. So you can have this. You can make a call. And this is for the Prime Minister. And this is the first call being done in the country.
Okay.
On the 5G.
On the 5G.
Communicating with my minister, who's actually right next.
Yeah. People would question that and say, why are they just talking to each other?
So this is the first.
The first 5G video call. The first 5G commercial video call.
Is it working?
It is. There you go.
And it says 5G on the top.
And it also says 5G. Here, please.
Oh, yeah, that's yeah. Fantastic.
There you go.
That's the photo.
Yeah. Very good.
Excellent.
There's one caveat with this. We have to be honest. When everybody uses that word, we share the spectrum. Yeah, they're both giving a little bit of that. But this is super difficult because nobody's
allowed. But no one got it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.